Let's go over the five main knobs that are on the Singer Heavy Duty Sewing Machines. You're going to find that they are actually labeled. So as I talk about stitch length, we have this dial right here at the top. The longer the stitch length, the longer the stitch. Usually for heavier fabrics, denims, fleeces, things that start to get a little lofty, you want to use a longer stitch length. If you ever feel like you have to push the fabric through the machine and help it, that's really not ideal. What you want to do is let the machine move these teeth quicker or at a longer distance to help pull the fabric through for those heavier things. So 3 to 4 in those thick areas. Now, lightweight fabrics, I might set it at 2.5 or maybe 2. And then when we do a buttonhole, it will be over here between 0 and 1, a really close together stitch length. So if I don't know where I'm starting, I'll always put it between 2 and 3. And those are millimeters. Yes, you get to learn a little millimeter settings with this machine, but it doesn't take long to kind of figure out where the happy medium is. This is the one that selects your stitches. Now, whenever you are looking at this dial, first always look at the black stitches, not the blue ones. The black stitches are what you get when you're in the 0 to 4 area. Those are the black numbers or stitch length related to these stitches. So when you want to get the blue stitch, you need to turn this all the way to S1 or stretch, and then it will be set and you'll get the blue stitches showing on the dial. And this is just one thing, as you just go ahead and turn it, you'll get those stitches. Just turn it all the way around until you get to the one that you actually want. So straight stitch is definitely the one you're going to use the most. Up top here we have stitch width. Now when you're not doing anything wide with like the decorative stitches, make sure you leave it on 0 because that's actually also needle position. If you're having it all the way over at 6, the needle is all the way at the far left needle position, or somewhere between the center and the left, depending on where that is actually set. So make sure straight stitch, sew with the needle in the center needle position, leave that at 0. Next, there's actually needle positions proper by moving this, and this one's a little harder to move from left to right, but you have those little increments in between. There's more than just the 3 needle positions. You can actually set it for that middle area as well. But if you need to be in the far right, middle, or far left, leave it also in the middle for when you're stitching the majority of the time. Now, I saved this one for last because this is the one that says tension, and this is where everybody always gets too excited about. You'll notice that right between 3, 4, and 5, there's a line, and 4 is normal. So if you have little fingers at your house and they've come over and turned your dials, and then you're just wondering what everything should be left at, just turn it back to 4. It's okay. It can be turned, no problem, but just leave it at 4. Tension gets a bad rap, and here's why. People use low quality thread, they don't clean out underneath their machine, they don't put a new needle in, and they think tension's the problem. I guarantee you it's one of those other things. I don't change tension unless I'm really using different weights of thread in my needle or bobbin. This is the last thing I actually adjust. I will usually just make sure, again, thread, needle, and cleaning has been taken care of before needing to adjust that tension. So honestly, leave it at 4, unless your book notes that you should adjust it maybe a little less or a little bit more. We will talk tension in a couple other videos, but you're gonna notice that throughout this class and these online videos, you are not gonna really see me adjust that very much. And if I do, I have a reason for it. But in other words, leave that be, use good quality thread, and when you have the same thread in your needle and bobbin, that should stay pretty much at the setting of 4. So that's how easy it is to pick stitches and adjust the settings on this machine.